it's first of all Ute Rummel. She's Terminology Manager at Plus, and later on we'll have Anja Petz. She's the Brand Manager, and she both they both earn a very big applause.
So hello from my side. Can everybody hear me? Yes. Okay. So I'm glad to be here. Thanks, Andrew, for this. Me and my colleague Anja, we will show now our challenge at class. And first, I will start with a short introduction of our company. So, this is one example of our big machines. And here we will have an overview of our company organization. So, we are still a family company, and our boss and the chairwoman, they are really present in our company still, and we have over 11,000 employees over the world, and in Hasewinkel, a very small town in North Rhine-Westphalia, there are 3,500. But many of you there will know already our big machines in the harvesting area. So the combine harvester and the foragers, we are market leaders for the forage harvesters in Europe, and the tractors. And more we are coming more digital for software and systems. So digitalization is also for the farmers a big issue, and that we will see in all areas of our company. So our product companies are placed in over 10 product units, product companies in USA. We develop and produce combines, and for sure the most combines come from Germany. Our balers come from France, our cutter bars from Hungary, and special combines for the Asiatic market come from China and India. So in our special case, we are really designing cooperative, developing these machines, China, India, and Hungary in the same type of combine. So really a cooperating project starts since many years now, and there's a challenge for multiple languages very high. So we encounter a lot of problems concerning communication internally and externally. And not only our products companies are all over the world, but also our partners and customers. As you can imagine, all our customers and partners are located wherever agriculture taking place. So all our farmers are in nearly every country. And for example, we harvest peppermint in USA or soya beans in South America, rice in India and China. So we are located in every small country. Wherever you see agriculture machinery. Sorry, I'm a bit excited today because the plenum is very big. So, but normally I'm more used to it. So maybe it's the weather. So, but as we know now, the language is everywhere. In the very past, we had the language only in papers, in paperwork 20, 30 years ago, but now it's becoming more and more digital. We have it not only in our manuals, but also on our web page, on our spare parts software, in our SAP system, and even in all the software in the terminals. So it's really becoming more and more distributed in our machine itself to have digital data, information, software strings, error messages, guarantee messages from the service department. And our big target is to get this language consistent and correct. So as we started 2012 with terminology management, many of our colleagues were really surprised where all the language is saved in. So that it's saved in SAP, and he is even not shown our 3DX experience platform from CATIA V6. So all our engineers are designing in a different system, which should also be consistent with the naming. So how to come from all this communication and information to a corporate language. Many companies pay a lot of attention of corporate design, so visual appearance is very important for every company. But it's becoming more and more important to have also a corporate language. That my colleague will later go in detail. So, but just to get the way to this, the design is important. As Frank said, he knows the green machines. If it's green and red or green and yellow, it doesn't matter. But we want to have the better corporate language so that we can be distinguished. So that is the basis. I'm a terminology manager now for 6 or 7 years. And we started with really hard with terminology work. So the correct wording for every customer of us, internal and externally, is very important for acceptance and trust. So this is what we can check with Aqualinks. And further on, we defined a good style for especially our technical documentation department first. So these were the first steps, very basically. But how to come from various texts to a really comprehensive text? So with the style rules for special target groups, as we saw, special audience needs special language rules. We started with these technical documentations and trying to support these departments. In 2013, we really implemented the plugins, and all our operators' manuals were checked with terminology and style check. So, but what's now new, we try to come to this corporate language, not to be just correct and comprehensible, but be also be recognizable. So I will explain how we check this first, because this is always the basis. If we say and talk about the content today, how it sounds and what is important for the content marketing, the first step is that the wording is correct, because then even you lose trust and acceptance immediately if your customer thinks, oh, it's not right what you write. And the second is really he needs to understand it, so it needs to be understandable, comprehensible. But this is the next step we are now going on, and I'm very happy that my colleague Anja from marketing really has the same idea and good progress to develop these new ideas. So I know many of you that know this, but I think at the first day of this conference, we really need to show what we are talking about. So for our every work we do, for our time-consuming work we do every day, it's really the most important basis for everyone, the terminology work. So we always think of the concept, we see the objects, and then we find the right wordings and define after our terminology which is forbidden and which is allowed. And the forbidden words are really very, very important for us. So in every language, I said, we have 4,100 concepts already finalized. And I think at least in German, we have 2,000 forbidden words for the 4,000 concepts. So the forbidden words are really an important value for class. So just to give you an imagination what we are talking about, all our terminology work is done in German, English, and French. I have a terminologist, German, English, French, and Spanish. So this is different from other companies. So if we really define a concept, we do it always in 3 languages. And since 2 years, we extended to Chinese. So we have a new company in China, and the suppliers and purchase departments, they cannot handle with only English or German drawings. So by now, all our drawings will be translated, the naming and the SMP description in Chinese as well. Time by time now, we are extending for new languages. Just a few days ago, I exported new Polish names. Last year, we had Russian from all our finalized terms, because we have many concepts in this term, which we show in the web service for all our employees, but only the finalized terms will be used in follow-up processes, translation, machine translation, human translation, and all our follow-up processes. So these benefits for class are quite general. So these are all the normal benefits everybody can face for terminology management. So you want to have higher quality of internal external communication, quick locating of information. So they are quite general, but there can be combined to different use cases, and then we can really work on this, that it, we won't keep it so in general. So we always think about these three departments, R&D, technical documentation, and sales service, because these are our main customers. So there is the main production of content, as you said. And the very beginning is always the R&D department, and later on the technical documentation and marketing will follow on. So this is quite different from other companies. As we heard, the technical documentation is often separated from the marketing. But our department for terminology management is in a central holding position called corporate R&D. So we are responsible for the terminology which is used in all these separately. So as we now combine our idea of correct, comprehensive and recognizable text and content, we can see the correct language is very important for the, mostly important for the R&D. The style guide is important for the technical documentation, especially the TECOM rules for better translation were implemented there. And then now the new topic will start for the marketing department. I can show you where we all already implemented the tools to support our colleagues, but nobody, because nobody would look individual for every single concept. We need to be implemented in all the processes for our colleagues, easy to find. So every colleague from the R&D department has the naming database where they can just select from this database and nothing else to name the parts. In technical documentation, they have the plugin in FrameMaker, and in the PIM system, there's also the plugin with AcroLink sidebar. So, and we have different apps in the internet for every colleague to see, especially the terminology with definition and picture and all the translation. And in the OnTram system for some special departments, we export once a week our finalized terminology, even Spanish, Russian, and Italian, to support them to get the best translation and the best matches. And the Quick Translator, that is our company machine translation tool. We use the system installation since, I think, 4 years. And there also our finalized terms are implemented, but we have the big challenge because it's only one trained engine. It's not, and as you may know, one engine cannot fit all requirements for machine translation. So there we are really working on. And the desktop checker from AcroLinks can be used by everyone who wants. And but we first train them how to use and how to understand the rules and the results, and then they can use it. So we begin 7 years ago with this. 3 years we work hard on new rules and better comprehensible text, and now we are on the way to a better tonality. And now I will forward to Anja Petz, that she can explain it in detail. Thank you very much.
Okay. Thanks. Okay. Thank you for listening. Okay, to come or to define a tonality or corporate language for class which is distinct and recognizable, we have derived principles, rules, and a special wording from our brand values. And I would like to look with you together on our brand values. They are named passion, agility, and reality. And they sum up what drives us, how we do what we do, how we want to be perceived, and they distinguish us from our competitors. Later on, I have to ask Sabine Lehmann if we are the manufacturer with a little joy, because if passion is one of our important values, we have to see. But I'm really interested in checking emotions in our text. That will be really, really great. We are not okay. So I'm really happy. Okay. Passion means for us, or you can see here in the little text on the right side, this is our brand promise that we give to our customers, and this is where you find the values as well. Passion means that we now harvesting processes and meet the highest standards for mechanization. Agility means that we make a go of what we know how to do and that we are developing and improving constantly. Reality means that we have been doing this for over 100 years, consistently, systematically, and soundly, with proven technology, with expert service, in a spirit of practical partnership with our customers. So this is the basis, the brand values was the basis for us to think about corporate language. To derive these tonality principles, we had analyzed a lot of class texts and texts of our competitors as well. Our central questions have been always, how do we want to sound at class, as class, how do we want to sound? And to make it even clearer, how we do not want to sound. And then we have brought this together with our values. You can see that here. If we want to show passion, we want to sound high quality and not colloquial. We want to sound confident and not modest, and inspiring instead of arrogant or lecturing. If we want to show agility, we want to sound active and not passive, humorous but not goofy, simple and not complex, and solution-oriented and reliable instead of superficial. And to keep reality in our text, we want to sound realistic, not exaggerated, esteeming and friendly instead of sexist or political. We want to sound like a partner, not like a mate. And we want to be specific and not vague. I have brought you some little examples here. So these texts are coming from a brochure of our Baylors. We sound confident if we say, with the new rotocut system, you can always operate at full capacity. But the original text that I found was really modest. Risk-free baling at the limits of machine capacity is ensured with the rotocut system. So we made a modest phrase more confident. Second example is a slogan which is called 2.10 meter working width for total work performance. This slogan contains a figure, and this makes it specific, more specific than saying another vital field of endeavor, technology, for example. Or here for agility, the slogan protect the ground, large tires, contains a customer value and is relevant for a customer, so it's solution oriented and reliable. We had a lot of superficial slogans as well in our text. For example, here, when it comes to tires, we are anything but narrow-minded. So. So with the help of AcroLinks, we have integrated and defined some rules which help us to support this or to make this principles come alive in our text. We have created a content profile for marketing, a checking profile for marketing, and these are some examples here for rules. If we want to be high quality and not colloquial, for example, we have to be careful with phrases which are overused, for example, clichés. And very, very important, and Ute said that before, we are very strict with, we want to be very strict with terminology. So AcroLinks checks, of course, the words which are not allowed and words which are preferred, etc. If we want to sound realistic and not exaggerated, we are searching, or we have implemented a rule especially for this, and this rule is searching for references if we are using comparatives. So if we, there's a rule, if we use a comparative in a text, we need to give it a reference. Otherwise, it's exaggerated. We want to give the proof if we do a statement. I think sounding active, not passive, is the rule is clear. You write in a more active way. And there are really good rules for making text more simple and not too complex. For example, the AcroLinks checks if sentences are too difficult, if they are too long, or if there are any redundant words in it which can be eliminated. So we use that a lot. These are only two, some little examples here. In addition to implementing principles and rules, we have also defined some topics which we want to talk about as class, which are important for us and our customers, and we have also matched them to our values. You can see here, for example, quality, technology, and comfort are subjects that belong to passion. And if we want to talk about agility or show agility, we talk about our targets, the processes we use, the variety we offer, or dimensions and evolutions. And if we want to keep reality in our text, we speak about closeness, security, tradition, and experience. We are a family business, that fits very well, and our customers are family businesses as well in most cases. Environment and conditions are very important in agriculture, and performance, of course. So, and here, now, it becomes a bit more complex. You can see the topics again. And we have defined some adjectives and verbs which we want to use in our text as typical and recognizable for class. We have nouns as well, but it would have been a bit too much here. So you don't have to read every word, but it's just to give you an impression. The words are in German, you may have noticed. This is because we started with corporate language for German only at this time. But I tried to explain it to you in English today. But I think it doesn't make sense to translate all of these words here. We have not only defined how we do not want to sound as class, we have also defined some kind of words that we do not want to use. No? The slide before, you have seen words that we would like to use, and here there are words or categories of words that we do not want to use. And these are, for example, overstatements, words with negative components, clichés, colloquial words, bulky adjectives, or nominalizations. And our challenge now is to integrate these love words and no words into the AcroLinks checking, because we do not want to integrate the no words as forbidden words to our terminology, because instead they are not terminology, they are really general words, and it would not normally would not be correct to integrate them like this, maybe with a separate domain. We are thinking about that, but the biggest question is how can we make AcroLinks or let AcroLinks check our love words. So if there's any experience or ideas here in the audience, we have discussed it already a little bit with AcroLinks as well. If there are any ideas, we would be happy to hear. But this is not our only challenge that we have for the future. A big challenge is, like in most of the companies, to get more acceptance and relevance for corporate language within the company, to make it really alive. We have to define clear responsibilities in not only in marketing but in all relevant departments within the class group, and we want to implement terminology, style and tonality checks into all relevant system and processes. We have implemented it already in some of them, but there are still a lot more systems that we are using in class where content is created, where texts are written, and we need to implement terminology and rules checks there as well. What we also want to do in the next step is to create a class-specific text structure model. So not only style, rules and words, but also give the writers a help if they start to write articles or text from the scratch. So a model on how they can build up a text which is relevant and interesting. And then, of course, in future, we will go on and define principles, rules, love words and no words, text models for other languages as well. This is very important for us as an international company. German is really only this first start, but it will be a good example. And then we have to work with native speakers, translators, texters, authors, lecturers, at languages and further corporate languages and for further languages as well. So, yeah, this was only a rough overview on what we are doing in class with corporate language. We are still a bit at the start, but try to make it more and more alive. We have trained agencies already with these rules here. We try to let them work with AcroLinks as well. We are hopefully going on and are successful with that. If you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to contact me during the evening. If you have some ideas and good advices, please contact me as well. We are always happy for good examples and some tips and tricks. Okay, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, Anja Peetz and Ute Rummel.